Once, a Zen monk named Boku was walking through a village. Suddenly, a man came up to him and struck him with a stick. Boku fell to the ground and the stick fell with him. Boku got up, picked up the stick and started running after the man. "Wait," Boku called. "Take your stick with you." Boku chased after the man and eventually caught up to him. He gave the man back his stick and the man ran away. A crowd had gathered to see what was happening. One person from the crowd asked Boku, "Why didn't you get angry when that man hit you?" Boku replied, "A fact is a fact. He hit me and that's all. He was the hitter and I was hit. It is just as if I am passing under a tree or sitting under a tree and a branch falls down. What can I do then?" The person from the crowd said, "But a branch is a branch. This man is a man. We cannot say anything to a branch that falls from a tree, because a tree has no mind, but this man does have a mind." Boku said, "To me, this man is also just a tree. If I cannot say anything to a tree, why should I bother to say anything to this man? What happened has already happened. I am not going to interpret it. Why get worried about it now? It is finished. It is over." The crowd was silent for a moment. Then one person spoke up, "But what if the man had killed you?" Boku smiled. "Then I would be dead," he said, "and that would be a fact. But it would still be just a fact. It would not change the way I see the world." The crowd was stunned. They had never heard anyone talk about death in such a matter. But Boku's words made them think. They realized that he was right. Death is a fact of life, but it does not have to control us. We can still choose to live our lives with peace and compassion, even in the face of death. The story of Boku teaches us that we should not let our fear of death control us. We should accept death as a natural part of life, and we should live our lives to the fullest. If we can do this, we will be much happier and more peaceful. So this story is a reminder that we should not take things personally. When someone does something to us that we perceive as negative, it is important to remember that they are not attacking us personally. They are simply reacting to their own circumstances. If we can learn to accept things as they are, without judgment, we will be much happier and peaceful. We should not let our emotions control us when we are faced with difficult situations. It is easy to let our emotions get the best of us. We may become angry, upset, or scared. However, if we can learn to remain calm and collected, we will be better able to deal with the situation in a constructive way. We should be compassionate even when someone has hurt us. We should try to be compassionate. We should remember that everyone is struggling in their own way. If we can offer compassion to others, we will make the world a better place. So, here are some specific examples of how we can apply these lessons in our lives. If someone cuts us off in traffic, we can remind ourselves that they are probably in a hurry and not trying to be rude. We can let it go and not let it ruin our day. If our boss criticizes us at work, we can try to see things from their perspective. They may be trying to help us improve our performance. We can take their feedback on board and use it to grow as a professional. It is not always easy to apply these lessons in our lives. However, if we can practice them regularly, we will become more peaceful and compassionate. We will also better to deal with difficult situations in a constructive way.